Well, let's start. I'm Jordi from Barcelona. And I will talk about Neo4j. Sorry for my English. I'm not used to talk a lot, but I will do my best. So I started working in Neo4j about 6 months ago. I was just doing an investigation for doing something new, because I'm not a developer. Excuse me. I'm a system administrator. All my work on computer is system administration, so I can give you a lot of answers about the topic. So I will try to explain what I discovered about Neo4j and so. Well, this is is the manner of you can save documents. It started with text documents and at the 90s before. And this is the evolution of the how the people store its data for doing things. And well, it's an evolution that we had. After everything else, I discovered that everything was going to Neo4j or GraphDB. GraphDB, it's the typical graph is I'm sorry. Graph is ¿cómo se dice? Hostia. GraphDB uses the mathematical theory of graphs for storing the data. Instead of doing the typical relational database, using schemas and columns and registers, it uses a graph to store all the information. And it works like this. Everything have a record. Everything is with nodes instead of typical columns. And it's every node has its own relationship within them. And the nodes has works as the registers. So They are all relations, and you can have every node has its own registers. You can sync all the registers to the nodes, and you can put relations between the registers. And for this, you have very speed and performance doing everything. What else? Well, this is a typical query working with Java. It's very simple to call and to make a node and to do a relationship between them. So it works like this. I can't explain anything else because I'm not a developer. Repeat, it's just a theory I see. So this can be used for everything almost. You can save social data for everybody, and you can expand it to anything. You can put relationships between all the nodes, and you can. You can query everything. What else? You can also to add special data, so you can have the geological information about all the nodes. You have to. Neo4j there is a function for doing special data. So you can mix it with like Google Maps or another technology it can do. What else? And you can add social and spatial data in the same graph. So you can mix everything and store everything in the same graph. Another example is financial data. You can also have all the stuff in a person, and you know you can discover what he did with everything. What else? You can apply this too to computational genomics, maybe, I don't know, to have a relation between a protein or whatever. Well, for creating Neo4j, there is a lot of options for doing it. You can use the framework or with Java directly. You have a lot of language bindings like Ruby, Python. I did myself an example with Ruby, the basic one. You have Gremlin, it's a very powerful tool for querying Neo4j, like Perl. You can also have isomorphical, it's something that you can match a graph that you set, and you can search on this graph, on existing graph, but it's on development currently. And you can use Snoop too, to do a query like SQL for doing a search. What else? Neo4j has these components. It's quite simple. It's just a half megabyte jar. You can download it no matter of time. These are the components. You have the core of Neo4j, an indexing tool, a Neo4j shell that is a command line shell that you can run commands online. The Java API for interacting and doing more stuff. The component for backups, as always, and the set of algorithms and all the graph stuff. What else? This is the typical uses I found that are best for using the graph databases. Data meaning, for it. This is the projects I found out customers for doing projects. Data meaning, you can have make algorithms for searching and patterns and that AI hierarchical environments that already have a or the VMS, and they need to be more fast and agile. Biochemical for doing the research with proteins or whatever. Discrete event simulation. You can apply a pattern and a behavior for seeing everything in a graph database and doing there was a study or more simple. Social graph, the typical you need when you want to build a community, social community like Facebook or Twitter, they are using their own social graph and they are using a graph database. And I found out too with my work as a sysadmin that network architecture, like doing routing and Cisco and whatever, or switching, it's very useful to make the routes and everything about the network. What else? This is so much simpler. This is a graph I made with a friend of mine and analyze the jet eyes and see it's a simple example for showing what is able to do GraphDB or Neo4j, whatever, with the relationships and everything. This is made with NeoEclipse. It's a plugin for Eclipse, and you can install it directly, and it represents the graph. Well, another example of routing, you have a set of routes and you can make a search and do the best way for going to a point to another point. This is another tool for visualization graphs. I think I took this from one of the examples of the office. I think it's a GitHub example with all the followers and so on. What else? Another tool for visualization graphs. No, what? Why? Why Neo4j? It's one of the most used GraphDB in the world. It's ACID, it's persistent, embedded. You can install everywhere, almost. We had tests with Android mobile phones. Since it's a very small jar, you can install almost everywhere. It's been in development since 2003. It's very scalable. There are lots of tools and bindings and frameworks. You can see further in the wiki or mailing lists. And it's AGPL version 3 and commercial. But for everything on and all the uses are, it's totally free. These are more of GraphDB, the more typical, the more I meet more of the guys of this GraphDB. They are the more options. You can look at the Wikipedia. There are lots of GraphDBs and kinds of. And it's all. This is all the. You can. The mailing list is very active. There are lots of mails and questions always, and they are always answered directly from the developers, and it's very fast to get help from there. You have the GitHub too. You can go there and clone Neo4j and use it at your laptop or whatever. You also have the wiki. The wiki for start with Neo4j is very fast. I use that for learning a little about Neo4j. And you have these two slides from two friends of mine, Pablo and Pera. What else? And I think it's over. I can explain anything else because I don't know. I have a partner of mine, Pera Urbon, that will do a more stronger introduction to GraphDB. This is what's just a presentation of Neo4j and GraphDB. And if you have questions, I would like to.
Yeah, will you be outside to take questions?
Yeah. Pera will be outside to take any questions because I'm just presenting this.
Okay.
I think it's all.
Thank you very much, George.